So now you've learned about the basics of analyzing algorithms, and we've introduced three simplifications that make our life going forward much easier. The first one was the RAM model, so that we can analyze algorithms without actually having to implement them. The second one was the concept of worst case running time, so only having to consider the worst possible inputs, and not the best ones, not the average ones, but just really the bad ones. And finally, we introduced Big O notation, or Landau notation, to be able to ignore all unnecessary details in algorithm analysis. So let's go back to the example from before where we tried to count the number of times that the sequence AB appears in a string of length n using this algorithm down here. And as you'll remember from the quiz, this was actually quite painful because we had to figure out what is a worst case input. And we noticed that this is actually not easy to figure out. And even if you have this figured out, there's a lot of detailed counting that you need to do. And there's details you need to take care of, such as how often is this line here actually executed and so on. So now that we have Big O notation available, our task is much easier because we can just make two observations and we'll be able to state the running time. So the first observation you can make is that the algorithm will actually go through the string one by one by one. And since it always just looks at a single character and the next character, the algorithm will look at each character in the input string at most twice. And the second thing to notice is that each time the algorithm does consider a character, so it starts out at 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on, it will perform a constant number of operations. So if it finds an A, it will do either one or two additional operations, and if it does not find an A, it will do zero additional operations. So for each character in the input string, a constant number of steps is performed. And this is exactly the advantage here, because with Big O notation, we can ignore constants. So overall, this means that if you have an input of length n, the algorithm will perform a number of steps that is some constant times n, plus some constant for all the rest of the operations. But using Big O notation, we already know that this is O of n. So we do not need to care anymore about the detailed number of times this here is executed. We do not need to care about the details such as how often this line here is executed. We can just state that the running time of this algorithm is O of n, which would also be referred to as a linear algorithm.